हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज थर्ड वीडियो लेक्चर फ्रॉम यूनिट 5 मैग्नेटिज्म. इन द सेकेंड वीडियो लेक्चर एक्चुअली वी हैव स्टडीड सम टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू मैग्नेटिज्म. सम मोर टर्म्स नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी रिलेटेड टू मैग्नेटिज्म. सो द नेक्स्ट टर्म इज मैग्नेटाइजेशन. Suppose a material, suppose the external magnetic field is zero, then the material which is kept inside here, the magnetization is zero. But if the material is kept in external magnetic field having strength H, then this material also get magnetized. Now how much magnetization is produced inside the material, that is called as magnetization of the material. So see, suppose this material is kept in external magnetic field, the flux lines passes through it, magnetic flux passes through it, and magnetic induction is produced inside the material. So this material get magnetized, that means this material possess now what? Magnetic moment. So how much magnetic moment is possessed by this material is called as, it measures actually what? Magnetization. So magnetic moment per unit volume, magnetic moment which is produced inside the material per unit volume is called as magnetization. So it is the measure of magnetism of magnetic material. It is defined as magnetic moment per unit volume. Okay, its SI unit is ampere per meter. Now when we keep this material in external magnetic field, the flux lines means magnetic flux passes through it and the material get magnetized. But how easily the material get magnetized? How easily the material is allowing this magnetic flux lines to pass through it so that it get easily magnetized? That property is called as susceptibility. So the ease with which the material get magnetized is called as susceptibility. You can understand the concept of susceptibility from this figure. In this figure you can see more flux is passing through the material, so this material get easily magnetized. And that's why it has greater susceptibility. Ka is greater than zero. But you can see over here now, the flux lines are not passing through the material. So the ease with which the material get magnetized is very, very less here. The flux lines are actually repelling. So the susceptibility of this material is less. This material is not get easily magnetized. So its susceptibility is less. And here the material get easily magnetized. So its susceptibility is greater. So magnetic susceptibility chi, it measures what? The ease with which the material get magnetized. Now magnetization means how much the material get magnetized. It is denoted by M. So this magnetization of the material, it depends upon what? It obviously depends upon what? One parameter is external strength of magnetic field. Strength of external magnetic field. If strength of external magnetic field is greater, the material get more magnetized. Yes, so M is directly proportional to H, and therefore M by H is constant. That constant is also nothing but what? Susceptibility. So chi is equal to M by H. So susceptibility and permeability, these are closer terms actually. Flux which passes through the material, magnetic flux which passes through the material, it also depends upon what? H. So B is directly proportional to H, and B by H is permeability. Yes, and now magnetization is directly proportional to H, so M by H is susceptibility. We are going to study relation between permeability and susceptibility, but before that one more term actually, Bohr's magnetron. This we studied actually in the last lecture, but in the list of the terms we will again revise it, we'll again define it. So Bohr's magnetron, what is the origin of magnetism that we studied in the first video lecture? Orbital motion of electron and spin motion of electron. Electron is a charged particle. So orbital and spin motion of electron give rise to what? Magnetic moment to a electron or magnetic moment to an atom. So the smallest magnetic moment possessed by an electron due to its orbital and spin motion is called as Bohr's magnetron. And it is given by mu B is equal to EH upon 4 pi m. Okay, so these are the terms which are related to magnetism. Okay, So you will be asked to define 2 to 3 terms for 4 to 5 marks or 6 marks, like that. So the question based on this is just define the terms or explain the terms. Now the next is relation between permeability and susceptibility, right? So these are actually very close relation between these two. Closer meaning of these, both these terms is almost same. Permeability means how much property of the material that allows the flux lines to pass through it. That property is called as permeability. Okay, how much lines the material allowed to pass through it. That is what is permeability. And susceptibility means the ease with how easily the material get magnetized. That property is called as susceptibility. Okay, so let us see relation between these two now. So, we will take again the help of this figure. Suppose this material is kept in external magnetic field. The strength of external magnetic field is H. Right? Magnetization of the material is M. So when this material is kept in external magnetic field, the flux, magnetic flux passes through the material and magnetic induction is produced inside the material. Now the magnetic induction which is produced inside the material is not only due to external magnetic field. It is due to external magnetic field as well as it is due to magnetization of the material itself. Getting this? If this material is not having the property of magnetization, then the flux lines will not pass through it and the material will not get magnetized. So the magnetic induction which is produced inside the material depends upon two factors. One is the external magnetic field and the other is magnetization of the material itself. So we can write, if we see this relation, total number of magnetic lines of force inside the material or total magnetic induction inside the material is equal to magnetic lines of force due to external magnetic field plus magnetic lines of force due to magnetization of the material. Okay, so total magnetic induction inside the material is B. It is equal to B induction due to external magnetic field plus B due to solid itself. So B is equal to B external field plus B solid. Now, the induction which is produced due to external magnetic field. This is the induction inside the material which is produced due to external magnetic field. Obviously, it is directly proportional to what? H, right? So it is equal to mu naught into H. Now similarly, the magnetic induction which is produced due to material itself, that is directly proportional to magnetization of the material. So this B is directly proportional to M. So B is equal to mu naught into M. So B of external field, it depends upon H, and B of solid, it depends upon what? Magnetization of the solid. So we can write B is equal to mu naught H plus mu naught M. Now just rearrange the terms. Mu naught we have taken common, H we have taken common, so it becomes mu naught, yes, 1 plus M by H. Now you know M by H is nothing but what? Susceptibility, how easily the material get magnetized. This M is directly proportional to H, so M by H is constant, that is susceptibility. So for this M by H we can write chi, 1 plus chi. So mu naught 1 plus chi, and this H on this side, so it becomes B by H. Okay, now B by H is nothing but what? Permeability, that is mu. So just remember mu is B by H and susceptibility is nothing but what? M by H. So this B by H we can put mu. Mu is equal to, rest of the terms are same, mu naught 1 plus chi. Now this mu naught on this side becomes mu upon mu naught. And this mu upon mu naught, you know it is relative permeability, right? So relative permeability mu r is equal to 1 plus chi. So this is permeability and this is what? Susceptibility. This is relation between these two, permeability and susceptibility. Mu r is equal to 1 plus chi. So if the material is having greater permeability, obviously it is having what? Greater susceptibility. Getting all of you? So this is relation between these two quantities. So this is all about the various terms related to magnetism. In the next video lecture, we will see classification of magnetic materials, behavior of materials in magnetic field, and depending upon that, how we can classify those materials. So that part we will see in the next video lecture.